Hello everyone, welcome back. Today I'm going to show you how to make vitamin C serum. My name is Obapa. The ingredient we are going to use is vitamin C powder, that is L-ascorbic acid. And we are going to make 10% of this vitamin C serum. So you measure your vitamin C powder. Vitamin C has a lot of skin benefit. It can brighten the skin and also it can reduce wrinkles, and it's also good for wound healing. It can help protect you against sun damage, reduce hyperpigmentation, and it can even out your skin tone. So that's one of the best serum that you can use to brighten your skin. We are also going to use hyaluronic acid, which help increase skin moisture and reduce the appearance of fine lines and wrinkles. It can help make your skin appear firmer. So it can help make your skin look very healthy and like very thick, let me say skin building. If you want a very healthy skin, go for this HA acid powder, which is very good. Next, we are going to use distilled water. So I'm measuring my distilled water, and we will be using this distilled water to dissolve our powders. That's our vitamin C powder and HA powder. And we will use witch hazel, which is very good for skin, especially those who have acne. It's very good for the skin. So that is the ingredient we are using. Add your vitamin C powder into your water and stir to dissolve. Make sure that everything dissolves. So you keep stirring, you stir and you stir, and everything is going to dissolve. The water will look clear when everything has dissolved. So now you can see my water is clear. You make sure you don't have any particles in it. Next, we are going to check the pH of our vitamin C water. Because vitamin C, it has a very low pH, I need to raise my pH up with sodium hydroxide solution. And we have video on YouTube that show how to measure pH. I haven't done my video because I order some ingredient and still I haven't received it from my shipper. That's the reason why. But you can use pH paper strip to check your pH. I'm using my pH meter, and the pH range I want for this my vitamin C serum is 3.2 or 3.5. But first I'll raise it up before I add my powder. That's my hyaluronic powder acid to it. Before, later on, after everything had dissolved, I will check it again to see if I have the right pH. That's what we do. Because the pH is very low, we want our vitamin C to work for us. That's the reason why I'm raising my pH up a little. And this serum doesn't contain preservative, because this particular powder, you can't add preservative to it. So what you do is to store in the fridge. You store in the fridge and you'll be using. So when you finish using it, put it in the fridge. So at least this particular serum can last you 1 week or 2 weeks. If you see the color have changed, you need to throw it away and make a new one. So now I have my pH and I will still check again. I have to make sure I have it. Checking pH take time. So now I have pH of 3.2, which is very good, which is very good for my serum. Next, what I'm going to do is to put everything aside and put my powder in it. That's my hyaluronic acid powder in it, and let it sit for at least 1 hour. Everything will mix well, dissolve very well. You can let it sit the next day. It all depends on you, and prepare it later the next day. So you let it sit down for it. So now everything has dissolved and now the pH is 3.5. So I'm good to go. I'll pour it into my serum bottle, use it morning and night, and this is going to help clear my hyperpigmentation, brighten my skin. And don't forget to store it in the fridge. Thanks for watching this video and don't forget to subscribe. Bye bye.